Welcome. You've got emo stuff. Saturdays on Planet Radio.
106.7.
With Hunter DeBlanc.
Planet Radio 106.7, the best rock on the planet. Welcome back to another SADurdays. That's right, SADurdays. I'm Hunter DeBlanc, playing all your favorite emo, pop punk, all that Warped Tour era music from the early 2000s. You'll hear it all right here Saturday nights at 7 p.m. Central Time. And you may know my guest this week as the first repeat offender that we've had. Our first two-time guest. And it is the end of November, but with me, we have Ace Enders of the early November. Ace, thank you for being here. For full disclosure, the third time that we've had Ace on the show, because I lost the entire first interview.
You know what? I forgot all about that until right now. When you said it earlier, like that didn't even hit me. That's right.
It follows me around every day. It is now the reason I make sure I have like three backups running at all time. I lost you and Chris Caraba in the same hour.
Wow.
So that was a big day of loss over here at Saturdays.
Man. Well, look, I feel like if anything, it made you stronger. You're built back like a machine right now. You're like T2, the Terminator, the liquid one.
I'm learning from the mistakes of the forbidden timeline now.
Yes, sir.
Well, Ace, how are you in the month that your band owns? They have a monopoly on this month.
Yeah, it's a special time of year here in the household. You know, we have a lot of fun. It's a wonderful time. Obviously, you know, I love it because it means so much to the band and all that stuff. But it is leaf season as well. I mean, our logo is a leaf, but dude, I blow leaves every single day of my life because I have a billion trees in my yard. So it's a nonstop work.
The early November is more of a lifestyle than it is in anything. You live it to the fullest. You breaking the leaves out there. You got the flannel rocking like you are. Like it's not just a name. It's a way of life. How did you guys pick this band name? How did the early November become the early November? What is it about this month?
Yeah, it was a lyric in a song that I made that like symbolized the end of something too soon. Like, you know, I guess the sunshine of the summer and whatnot ending prematurely, hence the early November, was like symbolized that. And then it just kind of stuck because we liked the original logo was a snowman in like the summer. But this is back like when I was a teenager, and now it's, obviously was shortly after that replaced with the maple leaf, which has stuck for decades at this point.
So every time I see the maple leaf emoji, I just say the early November.
Yeah, I love how that worked out. Yeah,
you guys are. It reminds me of flannel shirts that are like a wooden room with the old wood panel room. Just mm-hmm. like that's it. That's what I hear. And we're gonna let the listeners hear what I heard for the first time when I heard my first early November track off of their 2002 EP For All of This. This is I Want to Hear You Sad by the early November right here on Planet Radio 106.7.
Welcome.
The Band's Warped Tour.
Oh, Hot Topic. When did this open?
2 weeks ago. It used to be a banana republic.
You guys on MySpace or...
You're listening to SADurdays. All of your favorite emo and pop punk songs, both old and new. With Hunter DeBlanc on Planet Radio 106.7.
Planet Radio 106.7, welcome back to SADurdays. I'm here with the one and only Ace Enders of the early November. I Can Make a Mess Like Nobody's Business, and Ace Enders and a Million Different People. Just a busy guy.
Hit them all. Yeah, that's great.
Ace, how did you guys get linked up with Drive Thru Records back in the day? You know, you guys are teenagers. You're starting to write your own tunes. How did you guys get linked up with Drive Thru?
Yeah, well, you know what? Oddly enough, AOL, I'm sure you had an instant messenger. Maybe you did. I don't know. Maybe you're too
Absolutely.
Young.
Absolutely. My screen name was Hunter Eat World.
There you go. So that's how we first connected. We got Richard's screen name, reached out to him. My wife, who was my girlfriend at the time, actually did all of the communication because I was like very bad speller. Like I could never type anything. So she was like doing it all and set up a meeting. He liked the demo that we sent him. He was kind enough to actually listen to it. You know, that sort of got everything going. Now, I did meet with him in a previous band before, so I had kind of a little bit of a relationship with him. Yeah, really, it didn't take too much other than just getting them to listen to those first few demos. You know, I know that he liked the previous stuff that I had done, So this was a, it was, you know, really cool, kind of like a dream come true back then, for sure.
Do you remember any of the demos that you sent him? Did any of them make it on to stuff that you guys released?
Yeah, the one that he loved, the reason why he, well, jokingly, he always said the reason why he signed us was because Every Night's Another Story, which was one of the, might have been the first song off of the For All of Us EP. That's what got them into it. And then as we went along, you know, they were like, oh, it's more than just this. There's all these other different styles that are mixed in, because we've always been kind of eclectic in a sense. So, you know, it all just kind of made sense and it's great.
Well, speaking of eclectic, after, you know, you guys released The Room's Too Cold, we got one of the most ambitious releases by the early November, the three disc, The Mother, The Mechanic, and The Path. How the hell did you guys go, you know what, we're going to write 30 plus songs and try to cut three albums? What was going through your heads at that point? Were you just filled with creativity to the point where it's busting? Or like, did somebody ever say, hey, maybe don't do this?
Yes, plenty of people said don't do this. It's like, I don't know, when you're faced with opportunity, you know, a rare opportunity that not many people get, I think at that young age, I wanted to take advantage of an opportunity in a different way, not in the way that's like, okay, this is going to be the safe road that takes you down, you know, this place you could work with this producer, do some co-writes and make, you know, the next logical step. I think I was really like bent on trying to make a piece of art, because I would, maybe in the back of my mind, knew that I would never get a budget like that again to be able to, or potentially never get a budget like that again to do something like that. And we chose that road ultimately. And it was just all in the effort of making something that could speak to someone and connect to a wounded soul. And I think that was really, really, really the majority of it. And I tried not to care about the outcome, which, you know, it didn't come out perfect, but it's something that is really cool. And we're actually coming up just over a year, 20 years on that record. So it's going to be we're going to have a very fun 2026 with a lot that in the works. But it's a, you know, it's one of those that was a undertaking that, you know, I don't know if I'd be able to do again, you know, if I didn't have everything line up the way that it did during that process.
So we're going to let our listeners hear one of my favorite songs from that, off of The Mother, The Mechanic, and The Path right now. So this is Hair by the Early November right here on Planet Radio 106.7.
Welcome.
The Fans Warp Tour.
Oh, Hot Topic. When did this open?
2 weeks ago. It used to be a banana republic.
You guys on MySpace or?
You're listening to Saturdays. All of your favorite emo and pop punk songs, both old and new. With Hunter DeBlom on Planet Radio 106.7.
Planet Radio 106.7. I'm here again with the one and only Ace Enders of the Early November, and it may be the final day of November right now, but I feel like the Early November has a lot coming up. They're going to be doing the END cruise in February, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
So I know that you are a Hallmark guy. Did you know that they just had a Hallmark cruise? I know you're a big Hallmark movie. Yeah, it literally completely centered around Hallmark movies and the actors, and they do Q&As and stuff like that.
Wow. Oh, that's exciting. That's really exciting. You know, had I known, maybe I would have got tickets. There's potential.
Are you a big cruiser? Have you ever cruised before?
I've never. This is our first one coming up. Is going to be the one, the one that we're doing in January. I'm really excited about it. Honestly, it looks awesome.
Do you guys have anything special planned for these sets on the END cruise?
We're starting to get all that planned out now. So we've got all of the, we got a bunch of ideas, but nothing fully solid yet. We're going to start rehearsing, I guess. We have a couple shows coming up in the next few weeks. So we're going to start rehearsing for those, and we'll probably nail down some ideas exactly of what we're going to be doing. But I'm really excited about it. Really looking forward to it.
Well, I do know that they have a string ensemble on board. So if there's any way that you can get them to join you for Ever So Sweet, that would be the chef's kiss right there.
Maybe I'll bribe somebody. We'll see what happens. Yeah, that would be awesome.
So what was that like when you guys were recording The Room's Too Cold and you get to work with, you know, a string section for Ever So Sweet? Was that something that you had heard in your head? Was that a producer's idea, or was that something that you had a vision for to complete that track?
Yeah, I think we wanted to, I definitely wanted it to have a little bit of something orchestral to it, but I didn't know how to articulate it then. I didn't even know it was possible to get a string section, honestly. Like, I was like, maybe 2019, 2020, I really didn't know how it worked. So our producer at the time was like, found a local string section, And, you know, they came over, we talked, we went through the song a few times. He wrote an arrangement over the weekend, came back, and they just like, they crushed it. They really, really did. Yeah, it was one of those, that was my first experience with it though. And it was definitely something that, that you're sitting there and you're like, oh my God, I can't believe how much cooler this just made the song. Like, it takes some of the attention away from my out of key vocals. So it makes it feel a little bit better.
Well, I've never even noticed that. So maybe we're going to let our listeners listen closely for it right now. Off of their album, The Room's Too Cold, featuring a beautiful orchestra. This is Ever So Sweet by the Early November right here on Planet Radio 106.7.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
I just found a friend, one of your lies, to treat me so nice. I can't believe my bones when they say so many things.
Sadness. It's Saturdays on Planet Radio 106.7.
Planet Radio 106.7. Welcome back to Saturdays. That's right, Saturdays. We're playing all your favorite emo, pop punk, all that Warped Tour era music, and anything genre adjacent. You'll hear it Saturday nights right here at 7 p.m. Central Time. Time zones are very important and confusing. So Ace, we're going to play our cover segment, Covers for Lovers. We're going to play your cover of New Order, Bizarre Love Triangle. And I dig the shit out of this. This actually came out a couple weeks after you did the interview with us. And I was like, oh, I wish I would have had this before. How did you pick this song? And what was the, you know, it's a very electronic song, and The Early November is not a very electronic band. So it was a very interesting take on it, and I really enjoy it. How did this come about?
Yeah, I've been a fan of this song for such a long time. I think it's a, like, if you're going to have a perfect song, this is a really close to perfect song. Melodically, lyrically, it's very interesting. It keeps you plugged in the whole time. So we don't traditionally have a lot of electronics, but, you know, this, doing a cover like this is a great excuse to take part in some of that. And, you know, I do a lot of production, a lot of work with other artists who are electronic. And, you know, this gives us a little bit of the ability to scratch that itch for our own, you know, selves. We obviously aren't going to make an electronic record. People would hear it and be like, this is not what I signed up for. And, you know, that would be that. But it's great to be able to do it with something like this, because it's a little bit more freedom. You know, when you're doing a cover, you have a little bit of wiggle room in exactly, you know, how it sounds and how it connects with the original song as well as your interpretation of it.
Well, with their cover of Bizarre Love Triangle by New Order, this is The Early November right here on Planet Radio 106.7.
Welcome.
The Fans Warped Tour.
Oh, Hot Topic. When did this open?
2 weeks ago. It used to be a banana republic.
You guys on MySpace or?
You're listening to Saturdays. All of your favorite emo and pop punk songs, both old and new. With Hunter DeBlanc on Planet Radio 106.7.
Planet Radio 106.7. Welcome back to Saturdays. I'm here again with the one and only Ace Enders of The Early November. And Ace, November is coming to an end. Does that mean Yeah. Yeah. Are you guys going to get raked away and put out by the dumpster? Or what does the early November have planned for the next few months? I know you guys got the cruise coming up, but aside from that.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a pretty chill year for us. We're going to explore sonically what could be next for us. We're going to see if there's anything left under any rock that we didn't turn yet, to see what we might, a direction we may go. And we're really leaving it open. You know, we're really leaving the year open to just go with the flow, figure out exactly what the next year is going to be like. And I think it's just some much needed resting time for the 10 crew this year, because we've been going at it pretty hard for a little while. So very much looking forward to a bunch of one-offs, the cruise, and just seeing where the year takes us.
And could we expect anything from your side projects? Could we expect to hear any I Can Make a Mess, or maybe some Ace Enders and a Million Different People or anything like that? Or maybe just some Ace Enders by himself?
Yeah, I have a couple records that are done, and talking with people right now to figure out exactly what we do with those, what the best avenue is. But I will probably be releasing music early in 2025.
I cannot wait to hear it. And we're going to finish off by playing a song from some of Ace's solo work. And one of my, I don't know, this song is very personal to me and it always moves me. This is Gold Rush by I Can Make a Mess Like Nobody's Business, right here on Planet Radio 106.7. And Ace, thank you for spending the last day of November with us at Saturdays.
Well, thank you. I wouldn't want to be anywhere else. You know, it's a special time of year. Special time of year.
We had to. This is like having Santa Claus on a Christmas show.
That's right. That's what I like to think. That, you know, I'm going to start saying that. I'm going to milk it for everything I can.
You got to, you know, we got to figure out something to leave out for you guys, you know, like leave a maple leaf out for instead of milk and cookies.
Perfect. Perfect.
Well, Ace, I hope you have a great weekend. Thank you for chatting with us, brother.
Thank you.
Goodbye.